Boga trying to go on the run. Nice with that BKB popping up. Benny Mitch kills off the track. BKB up on the line. Mama triple over Ricky Maru up on the high ground. There we go. Nice wave bomb. Dark Tears on the run. And he jumped.
Welcome back, everybody, here to your Protota World Cup Grand Final. Canalogic Gaming going up against Pot and Bottom, the might of Sweden, going up against the might of Canada plus America. Who will come out on top at this point? I think everybody will be putting all their tangos, their bets, their cheese, whatever you can bet right now, including your mother, would all go on the back of Pot and Bottom. They are looking so damn strong in the first two games. This, however, is game three, and like all games of Dota, things can change at the turn of a hat. How are we going to go? Draft is up right now. Joining me as my co-commentator, my experience when it comes to decoding what is happening in front of us, it is the captain of Team Infuse. His name is Wagga of Amama. How you doing, man?
Wagga of Amama. Well, yeah, that works. Anyway, glad to be here again. And this game, CLG has to win, else they are out and it's already done.
That is true, man. That is true. $10,000 worth of prizes and cash get to go to the first place.
4,000 difference between winner and loser. So this is a lot of money.
That's something nice for Fogg's girlfriend if he wins.
Yeah, he could buy something nice for those 4,000 extras.
Shoes.
I'm sure
one pair of shoes.
Just spend it on that.
One pair of shoes.
One pair.
Anyway, let's look at our draft, man. Let's look at our draft. So far, PB, they're betting our Prophet, Lycan, and Lashrak. They do have first pick, yet they still want to ban out the Lycan. Pycat banning out Dusa. Invoker removed out again, so Fogged unable to have his favorite hero. And Darkseer also making the ban pool, but Fogged gets his second favorite hero. Pycat did a lot to make sure he didn't get through in the last stage, but it will be Tinker for Fogged first up.
Yeah, he does get Tinker, and it is very known that as soon as a Tinker is picked up, the entire way you have to play it is different. But knowing from the first pick that there is a Tinker, it does give you some... I mean, you can pace your entire picks on the fact that he exists, as compared to just a few months ago when he would be picked 4 for 5. 4 for 5th. And back then, you could surprise Tinker, which could catch anyone off guard, but... I feel CLG should be able to pick something that works against Tinker. Obviously, Morphling is pretty good, good against him. 10 seconds remaining. And they don't want to give it away this time. Aoi is not too, you know, he doesn't really mind playing Morphling. He'll do it. He takes it for a team, plays Morphling, kills stuff.
In this scenario, though, you can just feel the Broodmother coming out by Pot and Bottom.
Yeah, they love to play that one as well, and having Tinker and Broodmother, you can do some pretty amazing split pushing, and just the fact that they can never go in, and having
they've still got Enigma or Enchantress, they're going to go with Enchantress, and they take Rubick instead.
Rubick is good against Morphling, though, should be said. This is one of the best heroes to have Rubick against, if you don't count all the big ults.
But are we talking it this way, because we're just talking about the stealing of Morph ability. So we can
Morph
go maximum
ability
strength.
And waveform. And I want to say waveform is one of the best normal skills you can steal. It's 11 second cooldown, it deals 325 damage, and it maneuvers you. It's like, it's a very good skill, in short. So Rubick can become a big part of the game if he manages to steal first Morph and then the waveform as well. But we'll see what CLG picks up. I still think PB can pick up the Broodmother in the second phase if it's not banned out. Windrunner at your service.
Radiant. Looks like Lacoste will get his Windrunner into this third slot. Anaki with his Chen and Pike. Oh, Pike had no misery. He can take up the Morphling. At this stage, it doesn't really feel like either team is in a bad position in their draft. Both teams are. It's a solid draft from both sides. I always get wary just because of previous games about a team that does take an Enchantress, but PB, they showed earlier today, it works nicely for them. Lone Druid is now being banned out as well, so they're starting to look at Aoi's here. They're looking at what Aoi's can be playing. They already know Tinker, we know Rubick and Enchantress. Who are they really supporting? Or do we even have Tinker up on that top lane? Do we look at a mid-solo hero? I don't think PB run it that way, though. I think they're
always
support
hard
guys
to predict, but Fogg likes to play solo mid as far as I've seen. Remaining. And I would guess that he wants to have his Tinker there. But could be anything, really. Tinker has no problem going easy lane. But I like the Storm banner because Storm is a hero that CLG played against Mouse, and yeah, they killed.
It was exactly how they locked down Mouseport's Tinker.
They locked down the Tinker and the Furion. The global strat coming out of Mouseport was just completely shut down. I've never seen global strat be so brutally shut down before.
So ineffective? Yeah.
Yeah, it did nothing. The Furion Tinker combo that everyone is so dreadful about, you know. Oh no, let them not get these two overpowered heroes together. And CLG just raped them. So you can counter it, but there's a good Storm ban by Bottom. And DK.
It's actually a hero PB did yesterday. Bottom did that up. It wasn't against Catalogic Gaming. It could have been. I think it was Bottom did it against somebody yesterday. Hang on. No. It was in Brain's not gonna do it. No, it was last. It was the final pickup. It was the final pickup by PB. God, I cannot remember this game. Oh, it's frustrating. Someone in the chat in about 2 minutes' time is going to say, Toby, the game you were talking about that was live-streamed out, DK was the last because this game was this person. Shout out to that person who's about to give that answer in 2 minutes' time. I'll talk to you then.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's something that's happened before. And it's a good push. It's a good ulti up as well. And it's great whenever you have like a replicate, because that's what made me think about it, because it was replicated the DK ultimate form, and then Enchantress stole it.
Oh.
And then started using it against it. And okay, Luna pick up for Aoi on the top lane.
Start picking these kind of heroes in a best of five where you have two games up and you have some strategy. You feel this could be really good, but you don't want to risk it in a best of one, of course, and you don't want to show it in a best of three, perhaps. So bringing in the Luna that we hardly ever see, I would say, and bringing her in the grand finals of a worldwide tournament is the Luna.
The reason why we never see Luna, by the way, peoples, is because Luna dies way too easily.
She does die. It is true.
Very, very quickly she will die. If Morphling gets a shotgun, no matter what level of items Luna has, she's gone. She's dead.
Not really. She can stand against a shotgun later on, but it's just in the early game she is so squishy. And even in the mid game, she's still squishy. So it's only really
If we hit 60 minutes, maybe she'll toughen up a little bit.
I would say it's about minute 30. She can start getting really tanky, actually, and become a real problem. Because she will have lifesteal, she will have BKB, and she will have possibly a Manta. Manta is great on her. And which is also funny that Morphling can replicate Luna and get a pretty strong illusionary if Luna ever becomes really strong in this game. But we'll see.
I like
and
the last
Luna
pickup.
Is really how you want to lane it. And another hero we almost never see.
So I'm just thinking about laning right now, because this is leaning towards almost a...
So Rubik.
Like, you would say that Luna should be protected on the bottom lane by PB. Should be on the bottom lane protected. But how do we now run our top lane? What happens here? Is Rubik going to really go solo top?
He can. With boots, he can. You just give him boots, give him Tango or Salve. Salve is better if you're about to die, but with Tango you can trade some Arras at least. If he has boots, he's pretty hard to catch. Chen would have to smoke behind, else he will survive. And Rasta, is he looking to be solo or is he looking to be on tri-lane? The last pick is really going to decide this. I think he's going to be a support Rasta. Just guessing.
Yeah, I'll go with you. I'll go with you for support. It was the game versus CLG yesterday. It was the game versus CLG yesterday. People are saying it was. I should have not doubted myself, man. I should not have doubted myself.
Yeah. Earthshaker? Then it is a solo Rasta. Unless Earthshaker wants to solo. It can be done. But probably not.
I'll see, even just sent a link to the VOD of the game it was in. Oh, man. Yeah, hang on.
That clears out your headache.
Yeah, it does. So what, we're looking at a solo, it's going to be an aggressive tri-lane then. We're looking at an aggressive tri-lane by CLG for that bottom lane. Should be. Not gonna be. Not, definitely not gonna be. Misery's gonna have top lane as a Shadow Shaman. No, it could still be. I still think we're gonna have Aki and Miracle with Misery heading down south. Lacoste can take that top lane solo, and Pycat can take the middle lane. But I don't know. I don't think it will. I don't think What do we got right now? Sneaking, he is gonna go the side lane solo, but it's an easy lane for him. Fog takes up the Tinker in the middle lane. Well done to Sneaking. So we'll have Way Too Sexy as the Jakiro heading north. Times of Time will join him, and they'll be with Aoi. So then they're not going to protect the Luna. They want to be aggressive with the Luna.
Yeah. Well, they might protect her, but on the wrong kind of lane, I would say. And I'm not sure about this, Toby. Not at all. This Luna off lane, it feels weird to me.
It feels like death. That's what it feels like.
It feels like a lot.
It feels like a lot of death.
It feels like against Shaker and Morphling and Chen, you should die all the time with this. But it's their choice, and they will do it. So let's see. And wow, that's a lot of regen on Rubick. He can trade hits.
Two salves, two sets of tangos, and a whole bunch.
Lacoste is going down there, thinking he has a lot of regen. He will know differently. He comes out on lane. And Rune is being tagged. 5 seconds to go.
Oh, Pycat. Pycat's already in a little bit of trouble. He doesn't want to wave out this one. He's going to be careful he doesn't die right now. Is there another dual breath in the moment? Yeah, there is, but they're not going to follow him up.
That's a lot of gold being harassed away. And double damage for Lacoste, so perhaps Rubick will need his regen that he has bought.
I got to say one thing. I love CLG's courier. It is one of the coolest couriers in the world.
Yeah, this one is the little dino salamander kind of thing.
It's an iguana.
Yeah.
But not quite an iguana.
Not quite.
It's like the offspring. What was that thing from the Flintstones? No. Dino. Dino. It's like Dino's offspring.
Yeah. Mm. It's very cute on the portrait. Meanwhile, we should see Lacoste just winning this bottom lane in last hits, but he's he got 1 for 2 and he has some creeps to kill.
The DD helps him with this one, but
that's why he should be winning it right now. Else, Rubick is a really good solo laner. His Fade Bolt lowering your damage is annoying to harass or last hit against.
Yep. And, you know, his Tides of Time, he's already picked up double Sentinel. He's already got double Sentinel. CLG, surprisingly, they haven't really counted this up because we saw it was the way Mousesports got the first blood against Canalogic Gaming. On when it was Canalogic Gaming as the Radiant side and Mousesports as the Dire side, they picked the first blood beautifully, but it's because they were blocking the camp where they had a good position for it.
Yeah, this Yakiro is pretty strong though. I must say, it's a good support when you play against Morphling because his strength
fogged.
Is so high.
Good time to pop off a salve. He'll try and turn around and fight on Misery rockets, and not gonna be enough. Misery will take it. It's still got bloody close, 20 HP for Misery.
And Rune is gonna spawn really soon as well, so it's gonna go the way of Rasta most likely, and it's gonna be Invis top, and he gets it. Mm-hmm. So mid is now in the control, temporarily at least, for CLG, and he should be able to shut down his Tinker quite well on his own.
Seeing Sneaking. I don't know if this was intentional, if he decided to pull this one, but for some reason he's got himself a double wave on that bottom.
It's a lot of creeps.
Yeah. What would have gained this momentum, though? Lacoste?
It's the Fade Bolt. When you Fade Bolt, and if you don't kill the creeps that quickly, the enemy creeps don't deal any damage, and you don't kill the enemy creeps that quickly either. They kind of just stand around, and you don't lose any creeps. It has a weird effect on lane.
Just hearing but, a fun little ES fissure on top lane. It's like, what the hell's going on up there?
He is taking control of the farm, though, snaking on the bottom lane. Mm. Not that much, but he's doing some good last hits. Windrunner is a strong laner, but Rubick,
Would you believe that Aoi is the most farmed hero on the map? 12 for 6, up against Morphlings, 5 for 2. In a lane where
with the mid smoke gang coming down, I would believe it, actually.
Oh, man. This could be the Fogged again. There's the Shackle to set up with. Sada will give them the burst damage as well as the nuke, but Fogged still got... No, he's got no bottle charging. Now he's a chicken. Rockets, laser.
No body block, but still. And they're gonna try and go a little bit hijacking the creep waves here with Ench on top lane. Knowing that Chen is busy otherwise.
Aoi, don't go in range of the tower. You die.
You die. You saw He's like a little baby in your eyes, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He's like, you gotta protect him, man. Support that neck. Put your hand around the head and the neck. You know how to hold a baby.
That's how you carry a baby, so to say.
It is. Hey, man, I was trained in that area.
You were?
Yeah, how to handle a baby.
That's good.
My other life, before I became a commentator, I worked in childcare.
Nice. I like the Lunar Blessing, though. It's 14 damage on level 1 for every ranged hero. It actually does make his allies around him pretty strong, looking at the damage on Jakiro, Enchantress.
I still thought he would have put 1 point into the Moonglaive, just to see if he can get the angle right, do a little bit of harassment damage to Pycat.
Might do it on level 4. He might do it on level 4, because it doesn't scale super well from level 1 to level 2, Lunar Blessing. But still, 20 damage, it's a lot.
It's just that one hit, and the damage reduction.
Yeah, and it's only 1 bounce on the level 1 Moonglaive. It's not that strong.
So you don't overpush the wave. And moments like this, like, you'd be attacking the tower and it'd bounce to Pycat.
Exactly. That's when it's good. That's when you can harass with it.
Poor Wilkin.
It's flying up for Pycat.
Tornado started on the top lane, and Pycat was getting so frustrated with that one. The Urshaka came down and just popped the fissure to stop it.
Kill that thing.
I love how also Enchantress is taking the buff Chen creeps. I don't know if you noticed that, but he's waiting for Chen to grab a creep and then just stealing it. Yeah.
Got the tanky ones, man. He doesn't want the ordinary ones.
I want the good one. I want the one on the top shelf. Fissure hits on Aoi. Pycat still not harassing him down.
He's taking a lot of damage from this constant pressure, and it's gonna go down in this push.
This will be it. Morphling's gonna wave him away from us. They can try and look for the denial. Pycat's just opening up. Look at the miracle. He's prepping himself, and he gets the denial on it. But Aoi's now just like, hey, no tower. Let's dive, guys. I can't tank.
I am buff, and then you're not, because you're Luna. And he actually put his skill into stats, so it's neither. Stats is good, though. It does support the baby.
Yeah. No. Level up babies.
Yeah, all babies should skill stats, just for that survivability.
It's now going to be this new thing I'm going to invent. If I ever have, like a baby girl, I'll be like, you know what? I'm gonna make a game for her. It's going to be called Level Up Babies. And it'll be like the transition for a girl gamer to happen and get into this world of Dota 2. Level up babies coming to a store near you.
Sounds like you're setting up a little plan for a future here. You're always going to have viewers this way.
Gotta invest in the future, man. Gotta invest in the future. Start now, the viewers will be of
disturbing,
age.
Disturbing hearing you say invest in the future and talking about little baby girls, but yeah.
Hey, man, if people want to take this the wrong way, then that is their choice. But, we're going to watch bottom lane. Is it going to be a telekinesis? He's not in range. Try to catch up to the Windrunner.
Yeah, and the pressure is now going to be in bottom lane. And I like the fact that this Jakiro skills his liquid fire max. He wants to slow the tower's attack speed. And, of course, it deals a little burn damage as well. 5-second duration. It deals some damage if you hit a hero with it. But big part in a push is slowing the tower's attack speed by 30%. It's actually a big thing. It takes a long time for this tower to kill these creeps. Just look at it now.
It's
slowly hitting.
It's that loosened beam hitting. We've got TP support coming bottom lane, so Miracle's now rotated down to help Earthshaker.
But the tower's still gonna go down.
Surprised also we haven't seen Tides of Time raise the dead. There we go. Need those meat shields. Nice fissure. Gonna hold them in. Shackle almost gonna line them up. And, Tides of Time, he's walked himself into a corner, but then again, Pycat's gonna follow him. Jakiro has no frost stun. Surprising that. No extra level in that, but gonna use the dual breath. Shadow Shaman's killing off Tinker in the meantime.
Mystery.
What the crap? That was a war trap.
Mystery got a war trap, and I believe, let's see where he died. Yeah, he died.
There's a blood patch in the middle of, on the tree as well as on the wards. Did he get the tree bloodied?
Well, it splatters.
Oh, blood splatter. Oh, he must have got one of those veins. It's that neck vein.
Yeah, you should call the Dexter guy. He's an expert at blood splatter.
Yeah, Dexter. So, Dexter, how did Tinker die in the middle lane? Well,
it looks like a war trap.
He did something really bad to this person, so in the end, it was really worthwhile killing him. What?
He stole the Rust Awards.
What?
Yeah.
Rubik stole Rust?
Came back and Misery has...
I'm gonna laugh if Misery gets trapped by his own wards. It'll be the ultimate. He's trying to push him into it. Sneaking was trying that. He was so trying that. Morvig's gonna wave down looking for Sneaking and he'll get himself in there. But now Pycat's blocked in. The Centaur locked him in place. He strength Morvig for a moment. Jakiro comes in as well. And Pycat is gonna go down. Jakiro with the last hit.
A bit of a fail by Pycat. He could have magic sticked. He has a big magic stick. Should have used it. Look at it. 12 charges.
Mm-hmm.
And the waveform was just coming off cooldown. I think he would have gotten away. That's sad.
On the bright side, though, he does get the wards off Rubick. By killing him, obviously. But he dies.
Yeah.
So not that great.
I thought you meant, like, killing the wards. But
No.
How would you do that?
No, the wards that Rubick stole.
Obi knows the secret ways to kill wards.
I know everything, man. I know everything. The meaning of life. People think it's 42. that's merely a conspiracy theory.
It is.
So what has he now got? He's now got 4 levels in shock. So telekinesis, rockets, fate bolt. If he can get the shock off, it might be the kill of misery. And misery's turning around. Be careful, man. Do not overcommit this. Shock and right click 19 HP. And he still wants to go. He's got fate bolt back up again. The cost. He's on the run. He's bottle charging. He knows the damage which can come out from Rubick right now.
I love that Misery wants to help. He has like 20 HP, but he's like, I can do something for you.
Shackle from Lacoste. Yeah, a little funny with Sneaking, but there's a shock, and Fissure instantly follows up there by Miracle.
The shock hurts a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And double damage for Tinker.
While he's stacking Ancients.
Yeah.
He's multitasking. I'm picking up runes, I'm harassing heroes, and I'm stacking Ancients to farm. And there we go, middle lane again. Rockets, it's not even in time. Sneaking does get fissured up. Miracle trying to totem him up. And then Marsh Machines by Fog means Misery. Miracle, nice ward trap again by Misery. Shackle just holding Fog in place for a small amount of time. They're just trying to deny him. They're not going to work.
Still dies to Machines though. It's so painful to watch. As soon as you go into a march, you expect to die.
We are missing one important point. Luna is free farming on bot lane, while Morphling is also doing the same. But Morphling's got 45. Actually, no, it's not that different. There's not that much difference between like the top six farmers.
It's not a huge difference, but Morphling has died one time.
Uh-huh.
If he didn't die mid, then it would be good for him.
That's too also the fact that Luna's got not a single point in Moonglaive. Everything is into Lucent Beam, one point Luna Blessing, and the rest of it's Eclipse.
Yeah.
He's thinking about it. If he dies back past the tower, now he can... Oh, that shackle! That timing was just enough.
He does have a very good night vision with this Lunar Blessing.
Mm-hmm.
Bonus night vision is 1,000. So you have Night Stalker vision.
Basically.
Yeah. It's really huge, your vision.
I'm just wondering if we're going to see the Helm of the Dominator coming out from Maui, or if he goes something else.
Most likely, but I think he's going to finish the drums first, perhaps. It really depends. I mean, right now Tinker is using the stack anyway. He can't really send a creep there and stacking when Fog is busy killing it off all the time.
Uh-huh.
So I would say drums, just because she's so quick, this hero.
Tinker's losing a lot of life. I also just kind of realized the ultimate irony as well. If Persuasion gets stolen by Rubick as well as having the Enchantress trap, they can take away all of Chen's creeps in the space of a second.
Oh, that's true.
Well, I'm hearing Hex a little bit higher up. I think they're looking for Fogged. But then Marsh Machine still forces Misery back. Then Fogged is going to die right. Six charges to keep himself alive.
It's cool, everything.
Fissure going again by Misery. Rockets and the shock will get the kill. Fog walks back in again. It's going to be a double kill for Misery if he can get it. There's a shackle. The damage might be enough. Fissure trying to come up. There's the wall as well as the wards going down. Shadow Shaman does get a double kill. The Misery will lose his life for it.
And now playing.
Oh, nice Fissure. He can't reach Tides of Time, and the heal is going to keep him alive.
He should pull this one, and he's pinging this right now. Pull it into the traps.
Yeah.
Kill it.
Finish it off. Give me the farm. No, he doesn't want to lose. He doesn't want to lose his clarity.
Yeah.
He had to lose it in the end.
It's kind of impossible to do it.
And he takes one of the last hits, saying, man, if I'm freaking pulling this for you, I'm not giving you all the farm.
Yeah, I want the farm. It's nice XP for Earthshaker, at least.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, Misery producing so far 6 kills out of the 7. And he's being a big part in this game. And what did he end up buying? It was the drums. So that 330 movement speed is being increased. Pretty much, I would say. Mm. 19 by just the 330.
She prances, she runs. It's the power of the Panther, man.
And when you click that, you get very quick. You get bonus 10%. So then she gets 33 extra.
Pandas run faster than drums.
They do. They like drums.
Yeah.
Shadow Fiends like drums.
Really?
They do.
But how do they play drums? Their hands are ethereal.
Well, it's special technique. They have to raise it.
Ah. It's like Ghost. If you really want to touch it, you can touch it.
Yeah. And wow, Fogged.
Oh, yeah, he's in trouble in mid lane. Aki, however, gonna go down first. Fogged is still up, and the Echo Slam finally puts him down.
So dangerous to go in this. Look at HP. Like, Aki dies, and Miracle and Lacoste are happy to be alive.
Mm-hmm.
But they did do a good job catching him out when he was just a little bit too far out there.
TP's coming bot lane. They're looking to slow him. There's gonna be an enchant. The troll's gonna get the trap, and nice blink dagger on Misery means he'll escape.
Yeah.
And now Plycat's gonna come in middle lane. He's got an easy kill on Jakiro if he can get it, but then again, Sneaky just arrived, so maybe not. He's thinking about it though. He's really.
An easy kill if he can get it.
He needs TP support. There's the TP support now gonna come in. So Chen's already gonna try and send him back. How much damage can you deal in time? Oh, it is!
Yeah, the send home is not that quick. And he has to send home from Chen, so it's kind of funny. Rubik. It's level 3. If it was level 4, then he would have survived. The TP delay is 4 seconds or 3 seconds.
On 3, 4 seconds TP delay.
Yeah, exactly. And on 4, it's 3 seconds, so...
It's still hilarious that Rubik's got that.
Yeah. Sure. He should make an army.
He should, especially before he loses it. Because he's only got that for a very short amount of time, and that's a permanent creep for him. Instead, he steals waveform.
Yeah, he was hoping for more. And when he has the massive strength, he can guide the creeps, because his strength will show him as a natural leader, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good theory, at least. But already up to a pretty high HP, I would say. 1000 HP on the Rubik. Of course, he was solo, so he should be...
Fogged. Careful, Fissure will block him in. He's in a lot of trouble right now. He's got no Martian Machines, it's not on cooldown. Misery blinks in and shocks him to death.
Fogged has 7 deaths.
What?
Yeah. I mean, they're doing a good job of shutting him down, but he has 7 deaths.
How did... Maybe his girlfriend came home.
Maybe Misery got mad.
Misery
has been in 7 kills, namely. I have a theory that these two are related. And, Rashika just shutting off the path here a little bit.
Yes, we still look at this, though, and go, okay, well, Tinker's dying. But Aoi is finding so much space. And we know the power of a right-click Luna who gets farm. And we know what Aoi likes to do. He likes to right-click stuff.
Yeah, and farm.
Which, funnily enough, is like Luna.
So that's why they picked up the arrow.
Yeah. Because it's just Aoi's personal Luna. Misery's copping a lot of damage right now. Focusing the wars now on Jakiro. So Jakiro cannot get in range for the stun. Gonna get stunned up. There's a blink in by Misery. Morphling. It's the waveform on sneaking.
Very dead, Misery. Bit greedy, perhaps.
Yeah.
I would say.
And they give the kill to the Enchantress.
Yeah, this time dying for someone else than Tinker as well.
Mm-hmm.
And they are mad at this replicate. And then they realize.
It's a replicate. But they kill it nonetheless, and Morphling is stuck back at base, and Pycat can't jump out of that. And look at Aoi. Now bottom lane. He wants Lacoste to run away from the creep wave, and Lacoste can't do so. It's the reason why he's staying so close, and because the Lucent Beam was already used, there was no mini stun for him.
Exactly. It was very close, though. The cooldown is really low on the spell. 6 seconds for 300 damage nuke with mini stun. That's even lower cooldown than Balanar's nuke.
Look at the speed that Luna could just destroy a creep wave and push.
Yeah.
This
Morphling is getting a lot of farm as well during this time, I would say.
He's 93 for 9. 93 for 9 up against 112 for 17 Luna.
Yeah, but it was worse. It was a bigger gap 10 minutes ago. Oh, 5 minutes ago than it was now.
Well, we've got trouble here for sneaking. He waves himself out of the troll trap, then walks back in again. Lacoste, gotta be careful. He's already got one rocket. Shackle won't latch. There goes the frost out, but sneaking a lot of damage. He's trying to hold Misery in place. He's sneaking up on the high ground. Seek charges keep him alive right now. What's he gonna steal? Absolutely nothing. He waves in, earn charges, now being shackled up. I wanna watch this battle until it completes, until Tides of Time. That will not hit. It disjoints. Same with the rockets.
Nice machines. Wow, Luna!
Luna! No!
The baby! Pain, meet ugly. And she dies, and Morphling is still rocking around here. Pycat is looking for everything he can.
Ah, sneaking! back over the top of Shadow Shaman. And Pycat's copping imp damage. He's strength morphing out this one, but he's losing off all of his damage because of it. And Tides of Time is now out of mana, and there's a Marsh Machine to cover them all.
If he knew there was no mana, he would have kept going. But he didn't know running out. He could have killed. But Luna died.
Yeah.
The baby is 0-1 for zero.
Mm. She won't even assist anything. Well, she's young, man.
My statistics useless. Your investment is bad.
But he bought up, was that Wraith Band just before he died, so he lost no money. He lost no money whatsoever. He just gave away 11 levels worth of experience to Counter Launcher Gaming. Possibly slightly bigger.
He lost nothing, but he gave away. I was. Nah, but he does have Helm of Dominator. And does he have a creep yet? I don't think so. It would be funny if Rubick takes full negotiation again. And they have Enchantress and Helm of Dominator. Imagine the army.
Lacoste looking for a shackle. Rubick is now joining up the middle lane. He's still got waveform. There goes the Fisher, catches out three heroes. Miracle thinks about coming a little bit closer. There's the waveform down, combining with the Fey Bolt and the Breeze. And will it be enough for Telekinesis pulling him back in range? Rubick gets the kill.
It's really been all about the mid lane, hasn't it?
Mm-hmm. But these side lanes just keep farming. Like, we go back again. Luna farming on bot, and the farm up on top by the Morphling. But it's just fine after fine after fine to the middle lane.
Yeah, mid lane is where you go to war. This is the war zone.
It's the danger zone! Waveform down, misery's gone! It is the danger zone! He'll go down right now, rocketed down to death. Jakiro looking for the stun, gonna get it on Pycat. Fog still sending his ground. Marsh Machines, now Pycat will wave out of it, getting the kill on Jakiro while he goes. Sneaking, still has a waveform, he wants to get himself up the high ground. Now Luna with the ultimate! And there is nothing but heroes here! But it's not enough, he needs a right click, Lacoste! There's the right click, up the hill, doesn't miss. And now he can turn around, stun on Pycat.
She has it too.
What? No, 8 seconds, you're right, Fisher will go. She's gonna live, there's the waveform in by sneaking. Now the only 3 seconds on the ultimate, let her live! She troll trapped, the heal from Enchantress keeping Ellie alive right now! And Pycat, he's strength morphing. There's not enough mana left here for PB to continue to fight, but 3 CLG players are down.
Rubick is making big plays all over the place. Of the place. But yeah. Morphling.
Here we go. Tier 1 mid.
Oh, finally a tower dies to mid.
The war zone. Not demographic. Environment changes.
Oh, yeah.
The demographic changes. Luna is no longer a baby. She is now a young adult. She's going out and she's meeting boys like Shadow Shaman. And then Tinker's back at home going, you should be studying your sciences.
Meeting boys and dying. It's not a good.
No! Freezing, man! Freezing! Luna is an innocent youth! Think of the children!
Yeah. And look at this baby centaur also being killed off by its father. Aki, not very kind to his creeps.
Mm.
And, I don't know. The CLG lineup is good to hold push with the Fisher and the Windrunner power shot, but. I don't know, this Rubick is causing mayhem for him right now. With Waveform just going in, catching out the Rasta there, was a big play.
Yeah.
Just killing him instantly, and he has a Blink Dagger, he shouldn't be caught, but it's kind of surprising when you see Rubick Waveforming in and lifting you.
Yeah. Surprising to see, but it's starting to become more and more common. Lacoste looks for the shackle and gets it! Beautiful shackle here on Aoi! Waveform, Echo Slam, and nothing but death for Luna. Rocket's gonna come in and Pycat! He might go down! Jakiro with a follow-up, suddenly he's just standing his ground! Still holding his ulti the entire time! And Fold using a haste to run away. Has those BT so he can jump in and out. And starts the March of the Machine battle, just in case CLG think about pushing this. And wants to run back in for another one.
Wow, a lot of gold on the Morphling though.
Yeah, he's got a lot. There's the wave in. Man! Waveform just got stolen. Tries to wave it back again, but he jumps out to the replica. And again! Lacoste with the shackles! Enchantress will pop off the heel and get sneaking back up to his life again. And Aki steals his creep back off the Enchantress.
Top lane is being pressured by Rasta and up TP's to Rubick, but.
Into wards, this is not a good idea. He has waveform.
If Rasta knew he was alone, he would have killed him.
Oh. Is he gonna look for the tower? Denial?
He might kill him still.
He gets the deny.
He might kill him if he stays, but no.
No. Nine.
Misery. Being a bit too scared this time. Could have killed him and gotten the tower. Now he got denied and got no kill. But since he's been picked off so much lately, that it's understandable that he plays a bit more safe. But when you go for this build, when you go for Blink Dagger on Rasta, it's not about playing safe. It's about going in.
Gotta find these kills everywhere you can, man.
Yeah, and you will. Look at Jakiro's HP. How many supporters would you say have this HP with only Magic Wand and Urn?
What? How's...
It's a tanky hero.
Yeah. You kind of think about it.
Look at his strength and compare it to other heroes in the team that are higher level than him, keep in mind. He has the highest strength, at least base. I think he might have the highest in the game. Yeah? No, Earthshake is stronger.
47 is base for him.
Yeah.
But because of the...
Earthshake is also one level higher, so I think they might be about as strong. The strength gain is ridiculously high for Jakiro.
You can't really think about it.
People don't pick him up because he is hard to use, you know? You have to get in weird positionings to use his nukes, and his ice path isn't that good in the early game. The only thing he really is good at is pushing, but they have used him quite well for this in this game. Taking down at least 3 towers, but it's been... They've had to fight for it, must be said.
Jakiro is one of those heroes that... He's very situational. Very situational. Yeah. If you are going to go with that pushing lump, if you want to dive back past towers, if you have a semi-like setup AoE lineup, then you can start to look at him. But yeah.
What I like about it is, as I said, playing against a Morphling, the shotgun is not that strong because this guy is pretty tanky against shotgun, just by nature. Enchantress is, though, as we saw in the last game, pretty susceptible to the shotgun.
Yes, she is.
pretty susceptible. She does have a mech. And
mid lane,
the funny thing is,
set up, waveform up, is there going to be a telekinesis? He lost sight.
The funny thing is with mech, if you get shotgunned and you get your mech off when you are in the shotgun form, the E-blade, then you heal extra. So quick fingers is very worth it there. The cost, running into a smoke gang.
Yeah, this is going to hurt. This is going to hurt. Telekinesis, loosen beam, bring it back in again. There's that stun. And even Tinker was TPing onto the Centaur during the middle of that.
Telekinesis is dangerous.
And now middle lane.
Packet probably knows they are around that area, though.
Actually, they're not going that PB. We're talking about them being a pushing lineup.
Tier 1, though. Also, it's just a free tower to Morphling. They could have defended it, I think.
Now look at Bycat, he's just changing so fast into agility right now.
Yeah.
And fortification by Dire means they might even try and defend this bot tower. Bycat, he should have himself a TP, he just used his waveform.
They sack it. They want Earthshaker to finish up Blink Dagger, and he's very close with the gold from mid tower. And once they have it, they can make pretty big plays.
Well, using the Fae Ball to trigger.
Morphling looking for kills a little bit. Luna is still far from BKB, so Earthshaker having dagger soon is, and he has it now, is the key timing before she gets BKB.
Mm-hmm. Once that BKB's up on Luna, CLG can do very little about it during the fights.
Yeah, you have to initiate before she reacts, and this is much harder than just going. And they might try to bait the Roshan fight, having the surprise blink dagger now. I like it.
But they're going to get surprised on Tides. Blink up from Misery, Waveform, Shackle, and there's the just the adaptive strike.
Civil hero.
Yeah. Poor Enchantress. It's a slow, continuous heal. It's not like Chen's BOOM, my heal.
Yeah. It's really... You build up your strength slowly.
But the funny thing is, Falcon flushed them out of here. All he's got to do is get a good Marshall Machines up, which he now starts off. And Lacoste already cops damage.
Looking for it.
And the Marshall Machines goes inside the pit. Miracle, he could be careful. If he gets stunned up by Roshan, then he'll take more damage. But Fog's able to delay this.
Fly in on them, though. Enchantress is still dead.
Mm-hmm.
Could Sneaking. Be a good fight.
This is really a good extra disable, too. Four Staff and Yule's up his sleeve.
Yeah. And Luna is still not level 16, at least, but she's dangerously close. She's level 14 and a half, but Morphling
Sneaking.
Is very high level.
Trapped up by the troll and keep going, too. The wards will go down. He's going to take a fall. Echo Slam blinks in by Miracle. Follow-up Fissure. Even blocking. No, there's a small gap for Fog to get out. But Luna's already dead. And the Hand of God will
that
pop.
That is Roshan.
Yep.
I would dare say. Tinker being so low HP and no creeps to TP through, this Roshan is secured.
Yep. That's probably the reason why we're seeing Jakiro head top. He's just looking to push out the lane of the tier 2. So CLG take the Aegis, they've instantly got a fall back.
Yeah. Beautiful Echo Slam by Miracle.
It's beautiful.
Miracle likes to play Earthshaker, but I haven't seen him play it that much lately in CLG. mainly because Arke loves to play Chen and Enchantress, and you kind of want to have some normal supporter, you know, CM, Venomancer, anything like that. But in this game, they both get the hero they love the most, and usually when that happens, you will play better a hero you love.
How are we looking as far as that difference goes? Man, after that last fight, it was 2k experience. This is a way of CLG, which isn't really that much in this style of game. But now after that fight, it's about 7k experience worth. Going the way of CLG.
Of a blink dagger.
And go, oh, blink in, Tinker! Four staffs away, Pyke still wants to go, and there goes the trigger already. And it's going to be Sneaking turned into a chicken. Time to time will come in. Popping up the hill. Pycat wants to kill off Sneaking. Nice heal. Sends him up in the air. And Pycat's a little bit far out for where he wants to be. Now he's still sent back up by Telekinesis. He's almost dead and cannot get the kill. He's forced back out again. Now he popped the Ullman off for this little sucker. He's expecting someone to be down here. And in fact, there is. Misery is down there in the demon spot.
And Enchantress is the one trying to catch someone. But she's not the best hero at slowing people down. Well, she can slow, but if she gets too close, she will just die, and then they back after it. Pycat could have died with Aegis, and they could have taken the fight, but he decides that Aegis is worth more the later you go into a game, and there's a very long time until Roshan is up, so he saves the Aegis and just jumps out.
Yeah.
And everyone in his team got away, so it's fine in this case.
Yeah, why need to risk it?
Yeah.
You still got a lot of farm to go, you got a lot of time to
this
play around with.
And the most even game of the three we are casting so far.
Well, that's because the other two were completely one-sided upon the bottom's way.
not the second wasn't completely. I mean, it was one-sided, but not completely. Game one was the stomp.
Yeah.
But now it's looking like CLG has control of this game right now. And due to having the Roshan advantage of Dire, and pretty good heroes to fight inside the Rosh pit, except for the enemy team having Tinker. They could be controlling.
Look at how he's farmed. You want his BKB? He's about to achieve it, man.
Oh yeah, that camp.
That's a big, big stack. I think that was 5 in total.
Yeah, surprised by how he skills his Luna. He doesn't put anything more than 1 level into Luna Blessing. I mean, it is only a damage difference, but
you gotta protect him. Yulsep is in the middle lane right now. Cole set up on Lacoste. He's gonna get the courier flying on item. He's got the 10 stick charges plus the 4 staff. But he'll save
all
it all.
Healed.
Tinker very, very wisely cancelling that TP. I think Morphe's got his shotgun now. Actually, he almost does. With his bottom tower, he'll take it.
Morphling taking the tower, yeah, but I just can't take my eyes off a Luna farming Ancient. It's so hypnotizing. All this gold just running into her pockets.
I'm hearing Hex again. It's on top lane. It's Fogged as well as Misery having some fun.
Oh, he's low HP.
Look at him just channel. BT, 4 star bat. Where's the launch? Dude! And blink down, and then maybe! Oh, it's a bait! Oh, it's a trap! The worm was held!
It is a trap. He blinks, and then he realizes, oh my god, the entire team is here. But Misery at least keeping them busy with his life.
You know what the really funny thing is? It's still 7 deaths on the Tinker for 1 kill.
Yeah, he's getting assists at least. Yeah.
There goes a Fade Bolt straight through Pycat being pulled back in range of the tower. Then Yul stepped it up. A little bit of missed timing there with a stun coming out from Jakiro. And Morphling will wave back. But the Master Machines makes it impossible for CLG to fight here.
So Enchantress could
trap
be
up
to get a shutdown.
He jumps out the replicate.
His team is about to get caught,
though. 4 star, 4 star. Push up you go. Shackle on Lacoste towards one of the trees. That's what Sneaking stole. And now the mech charge from Aki trying to keep him alive. He's 4-staffed out again. Enchantress needs one more imp or nope, there's a losing beam by the Luna. The baby is now a man killing.
It's now a man?
I don't know, but there's again that double 4-staff in. And now Aki being brought back in again and killed.
And even a Yules with drums as well. You get a lot of movement speed.
It's such a fast initiation, like it's just force, Yules, initiate,
telekinesis.
It's
one of the most wonderful initiations as well on single target heroes. You just lift them and then you do what you want with them. You just send arrows and whatever. So the BKB is finished on Rasta as well. Interesting to note. Despite him dying everywhere all the time, he's been producing kills as well and getting farm, doing a bit of everything.
Waiting for that mid lane to come. But how's...
Yeah.
Pike still got the Aegis. Yeah, the Blink Shaker. Blink Shaker, Fissure, Echo Slam.
Is he gonna go...
He's going four stuff.
Yeah, I'm thinking he could go Aghanim's now, but why on earth would you start with the Staff of Wizardry instead of Point Booster? So it has to be a four star mode.
Unless he's just feeling a little bit low when it comes to mana.
But he can't feel low when it comes to mana. He has mana boots. Uh-huh. And there are a lot of mana boots in his team. There's mana boots on Chen, there's mana boots on Rasta.
Pycat, gotta be careful. There's a TP coming in by Tinker, but he jumps out the replicate again.
Yeah. And the creep was even killed by a Fissure.
So TP is cancelled, but... Oh man, and that timing. Fogged up on the top lane, board trap perfect by Misery. Holding Fog in place, and look at the agi switch. Forced up out for Fog, so the ward trap does nothing, and then he pops the Martian Machines up. It's like, if you want to fight me, have a creep wave.
Scary.
And there goes the Rockets. Misery's gonna die right now. He pops the BKB to TP out, and Fog's trying to rifle him down. He's gonna get the kill! Sneaking's here as well, triggers the Lincolns, tries to use the Shackle first, there goes the Yule set to force up, Shackle will go from Lacoste, holding, sneaking back out of here again, but that Frost hit, then Miracle jumps in, big Echo Slam, follows up with a Fissure, now the heal, but Luna drops in from behind, big Goldie just bouncing through the mall and just starts right-clicking down, Aki will take a time, I'll take a dive, Pycat will take a fall, and he'll try and live, but maybe not, jumps the Replicate out to Lacoste, giving himself a little bit of space to go, nice little jump there. There's still two heroes gone and Tides of Time looking to slow one down, but not going to happen. And why does Miracle... Yeah, Miracle's going to TP out.
They could have just dived this Tinker. They could have killed him, but they were scared about getting too deep in, but they were already too deep in. When they started going in, they have to commit... Rasta Tide again. Poor Misery. He played very good in mid lane though, controlled the Tinker, but now it's starting to get to him. The Marching Machines is just so strong, and Tinker's level advantage. Well, it's only 1.5 level. Still, Tinker's pulling ahead.
Yeah. How's it looking as far as, like, what, Luna's in front of everyone as far as the gold. What's the gold earned? Yeah, 16.4k going the way of Luna. 16.4 going the way of Pycat.
Morphling is farming better.
Yeah.
It's Roshan, and they do have four towers against four towers, so it's, yeah, it's mostly just Roshan and kills. Mm-hmm. He's been in, you know, 7-for-1 and 4 instead of Luna's little stats of 2-for-4,
Fog,
2-for-5.
Dead. Shackle, he's got the four star. If he's shackled up, he's gonna force away. Fissure,
yeah,
enough, stick charges. He's still four star in death. And at the same time, Pycat's gonna kill off Jakiro at the bottom lane. At the same time, Lacoste will die here in the middle lane. Now he wants to have a little bit of crack. He doesn't have his ultimate up. And Pycat's got, oh, what a shackle! Lacoste was getting killed. Now he's gonna get a shackle. He's getting imped up by the enchant. That's a long imp. That's a lot of damage. And Sneaking's gonna be like, sup! No, can't kill him. Morphling with a double kill. And they're gonna keep chasing. Tides of Time with a heal. Fissure to fly out. Shackle, right click, adaptive. And that's his death. 4 heroes gone for PB in the space of 1 minute.
It's looking good for CLG right now, definitely. This time, Luna was just farming the entire fights, and really bottom, their advantage is their strong Luna. She's a strong team fighter with all her spells,
mm-hmm.
as well as her spell, but...
She doesn't even use her BKB yet. This is going to be my bigger question for you right now, man. CLG getting inside the base. How do you do it when Luna can evaporate your creep wave in a couple of moments? Especially now she's got a Yasha on her, got the BKB in Cassandra ground.
Too close right now. They're gonna deal some damage, but not gonna take the tier 3 tower, I think. Mm. Depends on Morphling. He has morphed all the way, so...
He's gotta be careful too. Those loosened beams will bounce if he's not careful. And look at how he's just coming straight up. Triggers off the Lincoln Sphere. And he's farming up the wards while he's pushing out the creep wave, and the tier 1 tower will remain up.
They dealt some damage, but didn't kill the tower.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it was pretty foreseeable with the respawn timer of Tinker. He was just about to come out, so you never want to commit when a big hero like that is coming back. Roshan is coming up in just, you know, a little bit of a time.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
just under a minute.
She took all while of smoke. All five heroes smoked up as well. If they rotate the direction, which I think is going to be this direction, they're in a lot of trouble. They're going to walk up onto that ancient stack of the Dyers. The counter warning to check and see what's going. Actually, the Dyer's got perfect vision. That's the Dyer wards there. They got Observer and Sentries. They know
they
exactly
saw
where
smoke,
it's.
So
yeah.
They should send it in the Rasta Illusion, perhaps.
I'll send in a Morphling replicate. Yeah, there we go. There goes Well, Morphling Illusions.
That works too. Did you know you can replicate Morphling Illusion? But it takes a trick to it. I'm good at tricks.
Man, Poppy was actually pretty impressed with your trick with the SF and Venomance Awards the other night.
Well, this is another trick for him then. You can pick Shadow Demon and Morphling and replicate Morphling.
Sorry, what was that? I was waiting for the initiation. Going on the Morphling.
You pick Shadow Demon and Morphling, and then you just replicate the Shadow Demon illusion. Hello, Chikiro?
Yeah, maybe goodbye, Chikiro. He's still got two stick charges now being troll trapped up. Lacoste looks for a shackle. Not enough timing here, and Sneaking steals Morph. He finally gets Morph.
All that strength. Yeah.
He's going to get hexed up, and now see if he can get through 2k worth of HP. They're going to try.
Beast. Yeah, okay. He has no armor. He has no armor item, I believe, so he just dies. Usually when you do this, you have to run mecha, because if you don't have mecha, you have one armor in this scenario. Sometimes zero armor. And CLG are going to force the issue mid. They're not going to take Roshan because they know the tier 3 tower mid is such an easy pick off right here.
Mm-hmm.
And they might force a buyback is what they're thinking, but there is no buyback, so they can even push a little bit here on the Rex.
Well, going to drop and try and hold this. They can try. Rockets and March Machine going to push him back. Yeah. That's going to be it. That's Rex, man. That's Rex. Pycat can just stand its ground and do it. Where is this Luna? Pycat's still copying a lot of damage. He's got no Aegis the Immortal too. That's gone.
Oh, man.
I remember that was claimed. Aoi wasn't even part of that. He was pushing up bottom lane.
Aoi hasn't been part of anything. I just want to announce. He's been farming a lot. He has good farm, but his team is losing the fights. And they lost Rex. So carrying this will be tough. And he is going for the Manta style, which will be nice. But he really needs Manta and Butterfly before he can carry this.
But at least with his Mana Style, I can keep the lanes being pushed down because those Mana Style... Are we going to go? We're going to go. That's a blink out. They're going to try and shotgun down Jakiro. Mech Charge to keep him alive for the moment, as well as Tides of Time heal. Going to keep him up, and now he's ulti really starts to hit hard. Aki's trying to fall back out again, and now he just keeps right-clicking down, beeping that BKB up, means they really can't stand against him. Earthshaker was set up with a Yule Scepter. Aoi again looking for more loose and beams. Still no one's died during this one. Frost catches that miracle. Now they can focus down on him. Look at that first imp. Chen's going to try and send him back with a 4-star. Going to get him out of safety. Now back into Roshan, can Aoi bring this guy down fast?
Kill him pretty quick, yeah.
But look what's happening, Misery. Misery is looking over him right now. He's waiting for the time to jump in. He doesn't have wards from the 22 seconds. They're using imps to try and bring this down. Tides of Time's wasting a lot of mana for this. And Roshan, he is down. Aoi grabs the Aegis Immortal, and they're going to get out. Are they going to get out with the Aegis?
Yeah, clean Roshan swipe.
Jakiro. Bottom. Yeah, okay, yeah, now it's clean. He was in a bad position then. And that's full Manta as well for Aoi, and he'll feel confident enough to buy that now he's got the Aegis on him.
Imagine if Morphling already used all his 6,000 gold to buy this Manta style before the fight, then he would be a lot stronger.
But the reason why you don't bury your money in the sand, man.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't matter if you farm 6,000 gold if you don't use it, and he had not used it before this fight, so all that farm didn't really count in this fight.
And now we see big items coming out from bottom bottom. We get Scythe the Vise up on Tinker. And Manta Style up on Mirana. On Mirana. On the other girl who rides a large cat. Luna.
Luna.
And Sneaking just watching for Aki. Miracle's gonna come in, but he's already on low life. And now Miracle. Goodbye. So long. Farewell. Avidatine. Adieu. To you and your and Aki and Aki Aki.
Small staffs and Yules. He's gonna be used and
Luna's going to come in, lose some beam to get that mini stun, just start right-clicking it down and look for the bounce to go, but the mech charge will keep him up. Hand of Gods up in 9 seconds.
Look at Jakiro almost dying to Morphling Illusion. Wow.
They got Aki in the end. Lose some beam plus Fade Bolt and rockets from Tinker.
Strong chasing. Mm-hmm. So bottom are kicking and screaming about this Rax being lost, doing some really good fights after it. And they can kill through backwards.
Really?
Yeah.
I suppose you got so many alloys, it's not funny.
They have pretty much farm.
You got a TP back, but how he's got no TP scroll? This is his problem right now because he picked up the Aegis. He doesn't have a TP scroll, and someone's going to get back to defend bot as well as mid. Fog is now running overtime as off of defense duties.
Yeah. He is, and Morphling is just, you know, stalking over to enemy jungle, starting to farm up here. Quite certain that the enemy team will not have any vision over here, and he's correct in that. So just waiting for Tinker to come down on bottom lane, but can he shoddy Tinker? I don't think he can kill him. No.
He doesn't have the damage to kill off Tinker, especially now that Tinker bought up a plate mail.
he could perhaps kill him with the Manta style, but Tinker having the plate mail, as you say, is pretty tanky. But Aoi and his friends here, they're just looking for kills, standing here for like a minute or a minute and a half.
Aoi and friends should be so proud of him. He's growing up. He's making friends. He's making friends. He's finding kills. Oh,
that's cute.
It's a proud moment.
But here's the Hex for Windrunner. So big items going out right and left.
I just want to point out for people who've only just tuned in, because I know there's some people who do tune in a little bit later. At this point, we are in game number 3 of Pot and Bottom versus Canalogic Gaming. This is the grand final of the Pro Dota World League. This is the pro series of this as well. We've had some awesome teams in this one. We've had IG, Quantic, Mouseboards, Orange, Infused. Great team. As well as Zenith. All teams playing in this competition.
It's been a lot of teams in this competition. It is a worldwide tournament, so... And these are the ones dealing it, you know, showing who's the top two teams in online tournament, which doesn't really mean you're the top two teams in the world, but top two in online.
Yeah.
Definitely.
You're always...
No one can take that away from you. Ping issues or not, you're top two online.
There'll always be the phrase, if it didn't happen on LAN, it never happened, but...
Yeah.
It's meh.
It's always gonna be something. Then it happens on LAN and it was because of a cheesy strat or something like that. Yeah, it's always something. People are never happy.
there's always some reason to defend your team every you're a fan
team.
Of.
Oh yeah.
MYM forever.
Yeah, there were a lot of people like that.
Uh-huh. That's the reason why I was using that as an example. I gotta say though, Melk does demand a certain amount of loyalty out from his fans.
Yeah, true. But MYM was a very long successing team, you know, it was top qualities for such a long time. You know, trying to push here?
Yeah, they won tier 3 town. I don't know if they can do this, really.
They have Aegis on
loop. Look at how he's just... Well, Misery's thinking about coming in close, but just the splash damage out from the right clicks of Luna is more than enough. I think Aoi's quite happy to let the Aegis Immortal fall in this early engagement, popping up the Ullman, pushing Misery back. He'll wait for the Aegis to pop before he'll pop the BKB. So there goes Aegis. Tower's not down just yet. The Creep Wave is still there. Marsh Machine's just so heavy, and now the BKB can pop off. Pycat being stunned off. Hand of God's trying to keep him alive. Waveform out will disjoint the Impetus, which was going to kill him off. And now they go back towards the tower. And
no
now
he died yet.
Really?
For Aegis. This is like a big poke, I would say.
Facebook poke, but real.
Yeah, well, you always talk about in StarCraft when in Dota you poke sometimes. You want to deal some damage to check the waters. And this time they checked the waters using Aegis. But I don't think he wanted to carry this Aegis, to be honest. I think he was tired of it.
I need an extra slot. He's got 3,800 gold.
Yeah, looking at his inventory slots, he doesn't have place for an Aegis, really. It's good on him, but he would have to sell his drums, and he likes drums.
Mm-hmm.
And they see him. Are they gonna smoke?
Whoa. DC.
Big pause by the cost.
Yeah, we had Jakiro Lee, but good manners. That's what it's all about, man. Everybody in Dota is generally quite nice.
Yeah.
Unless you play a pub
generally.
Game.
Unless except for when you talk to them.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, Jakiro DCing in the is what is Aoi even referring to?
I don't know what this guy is all about. He sounds like he's in another world. Derpinator is the only response from Lacoste. And yeah. It's the only response he can give it. Pycat gives it a dot, and that's all.
I will take no more effort, but enter.
What Aoi is on about.
I don't think anybody really understands. Aoi is one of those players that's a little bit special.
The special group.
He's one of those guys that if there's like 2 minutes he can take before a match, he'll find himself a... He'll just like make up a game against bots. And just start practicing and warming himself up. This guy takes esports seriously.
Yeah.
Until he has to speak, at which point it's like skills in game, not in text.
Yeah, his way to communicate is way to DCO. Yeah, that was the boss derp. I have no clue what any of those lines really refer to. It's beyond me. But
we still have a moment, man.
Look at Chen and look at his top right item. He will cut people. Maim.
It's actually quite smart what he's going. Is there? But this is the funny thing. He's got to come in point blank range.
Not really, to
the Luna.
Very close. Very close. It's not as close as the Great Basher, the Super Basher.
Mm-hmm.
But it's too close for comfort, at least for a Chen, that is.
It's like, well, I've got to get in there to get a mech off, so I got my hand of God, so the chances are it's...
I used my ulti and my mech anyway. Time to die. I'll just go in and do this. And then he's done, you know.
I just got this image of, like, well, it's not like 300, but what is that whole thing? Like, you just take an arrow hit to the side. That's it. It's from Lord of the Rings, where the guy is just, like, diving himself in a blow at the wall of Helm's Deep. Cops an arrow to the side. I'm going to get there. Cops another arrow to the side. I'm going to make it.
Yeah.
Critical hit.
Keep going. He was lucky. There was no crit on these. Edward.
Could you imagine what Helm's Deep would have been like? Hang on, but I got a critical hit on that Uruk-hai with the big flaming torch. The wall never went down.
Over.
Yes! Awesome! Saruman's army goes down. The Rohan army stays large enough.
Is that the what's it called? The big monster that Gandalf fought. The Balrog.
No, that was always like, I always saw that like the Infernal. And when I first saw it changed up here in Dota 2, I kind of thought Warlock's ulti was the Balrog.
Yeah, it kind of was.
And then it kind of morphed and changed.
In Dota 1, I would say that Doombringer was the Balrog.
Really?
Yeah. He looked like it.
Yeah, I suppose.
Close enough.
Yeah. Meanwhile... the game is now resumed. 19 to 27, 45 minutes in. Welcome to your mid-game pause talk live here on the joindota.com live stream. If you haven't checked out
the journalist chicken is coming like, yeah, reporting from the front line, nothing new.
That is so going to be a segment. Somebody at the International design a courier that flies and will fly it over the top of the crowd at the International. And at one random point, it will drop a microphone and someone in the crowd can give their opinions on the game. It is such an idea!
It has to ask. Thoughts, Bulba. And yeah, then Bulba is there and gives his thoughts.
Oh, it'll be great. It'll be great.
Would be really good.
We always find stupid crap like this whenever we cast together, but oh. It's not stupid though.
No
it's serious. No. That was just mocking my tiredness and inability to speak decent English.
Yeah, but it's not a big part of casting.
Speaking. Yeah, you're right.
Not in your case. You're more about shouting.
Hey, man, it's. I still think some people don't understand a single word I say. I got this opinion at Singapore because everyone was like, man, you are such the best Dota cast. I'm like, man, if you knew what the hell I was saying, you would not be saying that. My first cast in Singapore was horrendous.
And first item was the 4-staff on Earthshaker. We haven't checked on this guy for a long time. And Gem is now being in his stash. So they purchased that gem at some point, or he just stored it?
It's flying out right now. I think they're going to smoke and put the gem onto Lacoste. Nope, Miracle takes it.
Okay. It's his. But a very mobile Shaker. I like the 4-staff because he can save his allies. And this is the bigger part in...
That's still risky. Really,
or get out after
he doesn't.
Ulti.
He doesn't want to lose this gem, though. And this Earthshaker is all about jumping in, popping your combo, and then praying to God you live.
Yeah, he gave it away.
Yeah, that makes a lot more sense.
No. Where's the gem? Gave it to someone.
Did he put it back on the courier? No. Who's got Okay, F5 is our solution to this one. And the gem is on nobody.
Yeah.
The gem is on nobody.
But
What happened, Toby?
I don't. Oh, it's sitting in base. It's next to tier 3 tower.
Dropped it on the tier 3. Yeah.
What the hell? Like, is someone just like, well, eventually we'll pump smoke and go in?
Well, the push is coming in and the tower taking damage from these illusions is actually going to go down through them.
Fisher stolen by Rubick. The tower is a 9 out of all of that. That's props. But look what's happening on the top lane in the meantime. The illusions were pushing in. The tier 3 tower's gone. The racks being harassed. Bottom lane, Morphling is in fact going to kill off Sneaking. I didn't think he thought that was real. That's not English.
Yeah, it is English, but Rubick, I don't think he was prepared for Morphling dealing a lot of damage. I guess you haven't seen him in a while. Morphling gets strong when you don't see him for some time. Nice idea.
I should probably point out the fact that it was actually too many double negatives. It was English. Oh,
yeah, I wasn't focused on what you were saying. I just listened to the tone of it.
Bottom lane, we've got Tinker. He's in trouble. Try and let up that stun there, and now the Fidget's going to follow up. Fog is in real, real trouble, but now in comes Luna. There is no dire creep wave, so it's going to be one hell of an Olin popping down from Aoi. Morphling wants out, Lacoste wants out, Chen will not get out from this one. Double BKB popping off from pot and bottom. And they force the OG back out.
There.
Yeah, there's a gem. Go, somebody. Chikiru?
They saw it, I think. Yeah.
Drops magic wand. Really? Wand for gem?
And he's like, is it worth it? Considering it. It's not worth it.
I want to be a wizard, but I want to have the vision.
Seeing the world as it truly is, or having a magic wand.
Way too sexy. He'll take the wand any day. It's like, what would Harry Potter do?
Yeah, it's... What if I took the red pill?
Why didn't I take the blue one? It's gonna come up later when like there's someone sitting right next to him in an Nimbus room.
Yeah.
The ultimate time is like...
There's on this twin dragon as well, so... Watch out for these supporters. They be maiming.
Mm-hmm.
Just saying.
It's like that little kid that just jumps in behind and just like kneecaps you. It's like,
annoying kid always gets you.
Yeah. Speaking of that, how's Luna doing? Butterfly now completed. Gonna go in for Roshan. And the funny thing is, Aoi can probably solo this. With the lifesteal and the evasion he's got, he can solo this. He'll have to drop his TP scroll and there's instantly the search with the power shot. Looking for it. Rocket Erasmus will fly off on both Pycat as well as onto Lacoste.
I like the Invis rune on Rubick. They know they took the gem, so the gem is dead. He could be scouting out, but he's being careful. Morphling buys out Scotty. He doesn't have buyback.
He probably
wants to get buyback before the fight.
That would be good, but he's not going to have time to farm that amount of money, man. Shackle won't latch here by Lacoste. And, oh, hello, blinking by Misery. He's going to look for the ward trap. BKB pops off, so he's going to get the full long shackle off on Sneaking. Neck charge, there is no extra heal to come off. Stun goes out in Pike, but Rocket Erasmus and Martial Machines. CLG cannot pursue, and Lacoste even just stands there in Windrun going, I can take this.
Really quickly. And they do it. They see Tinker top and just run into Roshan ever so quickly. And this is Cheese. Cheese.
It is. But who's going to be Cheese for? Like, we're looking at Lacoste. He'll have to drop something down for this
Windrunner,
one.
Windrunner or Rasta. Yeah, Windrunner.
There's the Agassi Mortal and Cheese
Rasta's
to Windrunner.
Golds. That's a rich Rasta. He has his Guinsu and buyback, I think. No, not really buyback.
And Shadow Shaman gets a Scythe device now.
Yeah, so he can hex a lot of people.
Ah.
Disabling 60% of the Radiant lineup.
So we've got a hex from the ability of Misery, plus the Scythe device, plus the hex on Windrunner.
Yeah, but Akia doesn't have his Halberd yet. He's slacking in his farm.
You fail!
You fail. Yeah. But really nice items coming out here for CLG. And scary as it is going into late game against this Luna, I think the CLG have to push now. And the smoke? Mm-hmm. There's a smoke. I don't think... They just wanted to clear an inventory slot.
Who?
The Radiant team, they just smoked.
Tides of Times here. No, it's a strat, man. It's next level.
Well, two of them are invis.
March for Machines, and here goes the Creep Wave. Rockets, Rearm, second March for Machines, and the Creep Wave is gone. There goes CLG's push. Completely out the window.
Yeah. It does.
Yeah, can you still believe, though, the pot and bottom are racks down? It kind of doesn't feel like it.
It doesn't at all feel like it.
But it's mainly because Aoi keeps on doing exactly what he's doing now. It's like push out the middle lane, and then leave the Mandasaur illusions to keep that push going.
And Yakiro is about to break the 10,000 total gold earned, and everyone is gonna be...
It's gonna be huge!
And he gets... No, he doesn't. No. Come on!
Last hit, last hit. He's just gonna tick over the old-fashioned way. He hasn't even got a last hit. Give him
yeah,
something!
8 more seconds. 5 more seconds.
4, 3, 2, 1. 10,000.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Morphling is almost up to 30,000.
Yeah.
And Luna as well.
Yeah, Luna's 27.
This,
we got 24.
The difference between Luna and Morphling is nothing. It's really nothing.
The funny thing is, Luna's last hits is a lot higher. She's sitting at 439.
Morphling has 11 for 1. That's a lot of kills.
Mm-hmm.
And Roshan has gone down to their team at least
twice. Twice
yeah.
now.
Not all 3 times. It was a steal. A very beautiful steal by Bottom Bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And just waiting for Pycats to decide to get Boots of Travel instead of these threats. So he can have TP again.
Wondering where Aoi's really going to go from here. Like, does he finish up his Satanic?
Satanic.
He finishes his Satanic, or does he try and go for something else?
No, he kind of finished the Satanic, I feel. It's really worth it. I think
he's got the cash for it now, that
when you crit on your glaives, I don't think the crit damage bounces. I'm not sure. It could bounce. It might actually do that, but it's like with Gyrocopter. If you buy crit on him, you will not spill damage on this one. The flag cannon will not crit, so to say. It mm-hmm. would be imbalanced.
Yeah.
But on Luna, it might just work, but... Satanic is great to have that survivability, and it's gonna be a Satanic. He flies up the recipe, and Satanic now looks like Batman. That's pretty cool.
What?
It does. Haven't you seen the new icon?
Satanic?
Look at the recipe.
I'm
Hold
Batman.
Over the recipe right now.
It does. It looks like a Batarang.
Yeah? It's the Batarang.
Hang on, no. I know what episode this is from. Is Batman Forever?
Well, meanwhile, we see Push coming in on mid lane. And bottom lane... I think Taker is going to be jumped on, but gets back in time.
Jumping already by Sneaking. He's finding Lacoste. All they want to do is just bring down the tower, and now he does have that Satanic to fight this one. Look at the bounces just flying through Lacoste, as well as the Chen army. Lacoste comes out. Pycat's here. There's the BKB TP out by Aoi. Nothing can stop that one.
Well, he moved him.
And then BKB TP by Tides of War. Pycat, that's a lot of damage.
Yeah,
but not
just
enough.
Just displaying his power.
Yeah. I'm Pycat.
I hit Enchantress.
And then Fog just keeps the top lane pushed out. He held the bottom lane, and Aoi's going to give it some momentum towards his bottom lane as well, and then retreat back.
I was going to say, it looks as if Enchantress doesn't even have Untouchable when he was attacking her, but look at Enchantress' skill build, and that makes
it's 1 point Untouchable.
It's level 1 and level 2 on Enchant, so a lot in stats, trying to survive the Shuffy.
And he needs mana for the Imps, man, as well. Look at Fog, there's rockets again, Martian Machines, Creep Wave's basically gone. Fade Bolt means they don't push in even harder. And CLG want to rotate bot, but the Creep Wave hasn't entered, so the backdoor regen is still there. And the bottom lane got pushed out because Luna left the illusions pushing out the bottom lane. So the momentum is completely against. This lane push has stopped. And look at top lane. CLG have got a TP back one player, or else they're going to lose Rax.
Yeah, it's...
Or is that why we're seeing Morphling now move as the Chen replicate?
Yeah, but he... would ideally want to TP home and then replicate back, but he doesn't have travels yet. He should buy it up, and he will do it.
Look at Aoi. Well, this keeps going
to buy one more big item.
Aoi keeps on finding farm. He's going to get his buy back after this creep wave down here.
Yeah, a little bit more. You need to have pretty much gold this long into a game, because when you die, you lose a lot unless you have everything in reliable gold.
Mm-hmm.
But creeps don't give reliable gold. They get trash.
Just nothing. It's like what you find on the street.
Well, sometimes when you die, you lose so much gold, especially if you're a Pycat in this scenario. You have 11 for 1. I don't know what his streak is right now. Godlike, something like that.
It's got to be pretty high, man.
Beyond Godlike. We could say it like that. He will lose around 800 gold or something when he dies. Mm-hmm. It's horrific, you know? You just die and lose everything. So just having the buyback mark of gold is not enough. You need to have more.
Kind of wondering what's going to happen here with Chen. I'm watching him with that Sanj, but
is he going to buy it now, or will he save for buyback? It's 200 more gold.
Well, I'm just thinking, why did he go Sanj when you could have had Aghanim Scepter?
Sanj is not as cheap
Well, not as expensive as Aghanim's.
Yeah, but to buy the full halberd, that costs you almost as much as an Aghanim's.
Yeah, but on the other side, it's expensive components and so on and so forth. This one only costs a little bit, you know, 2,000 gold, and you get a lot of strength for it. So you can tank.
There's something in the water on the top lane.
Yeah, there's...
Yellow for a kill.
Brewing, and there's a drawing of something, a snake, a green snake.
This is a... CLG is going to run this way and try and kill us off here. While they do that, why don't we just push top and take Rax?
Yeah, I think if they come to the Rax on top lane, which they will now, they will get the Rax. So that's why CLG are smoking and trying to get them outside base.
Question is going to be who gets the vision first. Chikiro, worst position, Chikiro is instantly hexed and will get nuked down. Look at Pycast damage. Owie will now pop off his ultimate. There's a couple of centaurs coming in with a BKB, TP back out again. He will get out to safety. And
I love that he always throws his Fissure on him when he's BKB.
I don't know if you've also seen top lane, man. These Mana Style Illusions are going to push in and help to bring down the creep wave. There's that TP already. Morphling returns.
Funny thing is, there are some things that don't trigger backdoor region. Illusions is one of them. You can backdoor illusions and it won't trigger. And you can use... I hope it's been fixed, but you can use Leshrac's Edict to backdoor and it won't trigger.
I love this line being drawn by CLG, and I know exactly the reason why. Because Pycat at this point has Aegis the Immortal, so he'll come back up again. But then he'll also buy back and then use his BTs to return to the fight. You're basically, in this next engagement, it's three Morphlings over. So PB, they're going to make sure when Morphling is dead, they get rid of these supports.
And BKB is refreshed by Luna, so she doesn't have buyback. This is... If
ballsy.
CLG goes now, this could be so good.
This is
kill
ballsy.
Luna once and it's GG, basically.
Sneaking again. God, be careful. He got caught out last time around Roshan.
He has a lot of survivability items, to be fair. And if they go on him, they could get a pretty nice fight, I think, bottom. But this is so dangerous. If Luna dies, I dare say they need to do a heavenly fight, else it's GG.
They don't have that up. They don't have the heavenly part yet. Oh, wait, no, Chen! Heaven's Halberd has arrived.
Heaven. That's nice.
And he bought out for that. He bought
Roshan
out.
Roshan is soon up, just saying, so... The Aegis is not trustworthy for much longer. It's about 1 minute now. Exactly 1 minute.
Mm-hmm. Ticking it down. Hey, you can read the time. A player can read the time.
Yeah. Let's see if they want to use it first and then go and they find a DD. It would be so beautiful to go for a fight right now.
I was going
to
remember too, it's going to be a double
you
cheese.
You will kill the Ancients in a few hits. Look.
Yeah, Pycat's looking
five
good.
I mean,
it's also a Monkey King bar to come up for the Windrunner if he's going to spend the cash.
Oh, yeah.
Already having the Demon Edge and having 4k gold
that
off the
sleeve. That would be nice. Then they can actually bring down the Luna a bit easier with the Focus Fire.
Are they going to get the Aegis Immortal Aki? Because I'm just thinking right now, it can go back to Pycat, but there's also going to be a secondary cheese up on the field. And who's going to be better to have an Aegis Immortal right now? Would you still give it to Pycat?
Yes.
Okay,
would.
Summary, done. He's one-hitting creep from...
But he has buyback money and, you know, but...
He's got 7.2k! That's more than buyback money!
I know, but the thing is, if he dies, even with his 7k gold and he uses that to buy something awesome, then he dies and he only has buyback. But
Roshan.
Having, as you said, buyback and Aegis and TP to base, it's three Morphlings.
Roshan's down half-life now. And gone.
No, they don't. And he wants an item. So, Cheese on Earthshaker, and Aegis on Rasta, and Cheese on Windrunner. Everyone is pretty tanky now, I have to be said.
So, Morphling, what does he buy? Rapier? 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 No, back! Rapier? Yeah, Pycat? Pycat? What did he buy? He bought Demon Edge!
He's teasing
He's
us.
Getting Monkey King Bar! He's getting Monkey King Bar!
Yeah, it's gonna be MKB. And
damn it to hell!
Open. And what does he need to buy?
Oh no, it'll be Daedalus. It'll be Daedalus. He'll go crit.
No. What will he need to buy to finish up the MKB, Toby?
Two javelins.
No, that's not how he say it.
Two javelins.
This is like the part in Pink Panther when he's trying to order a cheeseburger. Did you see that?
I am not going to grace that with an answer. We got middle lane trying to have some fun here. Misery thinking about going into a double Marshall machine wave.
No. Oh yeah, so it's a double Marshall machine, but it's two javelins. Oh man, you're so evil.
Damn you to hell, man.
Is it a dabble matcher?
Screw you.
This damage on Morphling though, it's gonna be really hard for his Luna if Lacoste finishes up his MKB as well, which he could do safely. Oh,
problem though we're gonna have right now is the fact that Morphling is not engaged in this fight in the middle lane. We're already gonna go. There's the blink in. He's called out two heroes. Gonna follow up with another Fidget. Misery up with a BKB. Forsarving sneaking away, but Owie is just gonna stand here on the backside with a BKB. Look at the right click damage. It's ripping Misery apart. Now he wants Aki. There will be the TP coming in by Morphling, and he's trying to push Owie back out again. This is a big fight. The big carries. There needs to be a support kill right now. Instant buyback's gonna be coming back out by Luna, which he will do so. There goes the Shadow Shaman, and now the right click on Tides of Time. Pycat is just way, way too fat. Fog is a chicken. He will go down as well. Another buyback. Triple kill for Pycat. Buyback by Tinker. Let's keep going, boys. That gong hasn't popped off enough yet. The illusions will push out the top lane, but CLG gonna go straight through the mid. Miracle looking to jump in again. He's actually looking towards the bot lane. They want quick racks, and they're gonna get it as well.
Still have buyback on Morphling. This should be over.
Here's now Tides of Time, trying to rise him down. Shackle won't latch. Marsh the Machine's gonna start off again. Strength Morphling coming up here, and they're gonna be careful not to overextend. Miracle's copping a lot of damage. Almost enough to kill him off. 18 HP he went down to. And Chen will start sending them back, but PB, they will defend for now.
Keep going.
Maybe they can find Lacoste. Owie wants to get in close. There's a sudden Lacoste. They're almost trying to bait this fight out from the high ground.
Yeah, the fight is still gonna happen, I feel. But the creeps are over here, someone says. Morphling will have to go there and clear them out. He has 14 seconds. Now they send on Earthshake as well, because he has no HP at all.
That's enough time. Wave, right click, boom, 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 boom,
He should buy a PKP. He does it. I love him. He does it right after I say it as well. Miracle listening to me. This is such an epic game though, but look at that Morphling. As soon as he gets in a one-on-one with Luna, there is no doubt about who's the stronger one-on-one. Mm-hmm. But Luna can clear out the entire team if she doesn't get locked down. I think he's going for a BKB.
Oh, Misery! Lacoste on the way out. He's going to be pulled back in again. He doesn't have a 4-star right now, and the TP will be coming. No, it won't. Lacoste going to go down.
Wow.
That's a big kill to get, and I don't... Yeah, he's got buyback. He's got buyback. But he won't want to waste the cash.
They didn't use a lot of buybacks in their dire lineup, so they still can't really push, but that, you know, makes it so they can't finish it yet. Mm-hmm. But Luna, they're gonna force the buyback. This they have to do. If they don't force buybacks, that's a big waste of a kill. Should always use this.
I don't know if you've seen, but Luna's bought out. Owie bought a Demon Edge. That's his incomplete buyback gone.
Yeah, I know. They should just poke, force the buyback, and then back, but they're looking for kills on Chen.
They might even find him, too. They're moving up pretty fast. Tides of Time trying to come in. They find his Centaur.
Is
and
real.
Now Tides of Time, horrible place to be in. Rocket's still going to fly. Yul's up to Holy Shadow Shaman out. The stun will fly straight through perfectly, combining it with the Jakira Orman and Owie. He is going to mop up the supports. Miracle's in the midst of all of this, but look at the damage Owie's going to do. It's a double. It's going to be a triple Pycat from the high ground. That's not what you want to fight, but Satanic will pop off, and now he gets all of his life back. They're holding Pycat out. Too much damage for him to deal with. They've got to keep this push going on top. Three down for CLG right now. There's a replicate behind, but they can bring down this Rax, or can they? Damage through, look at the bounce damage that's going out on Pycat! Too much! Waves up, he's still bringing down a lot of damage. Owie locked in position, he's gotta keep that right click going, it's not gonna be too much. Lacoste be the Monkey King Bar, doing the damage from behind, and there goes Luna. He is down the sidelines. This could be GG in a moment, but that's a big way pushing on the top. Tides of Time will take a fall as well.
It's gonna turn, and Luna does not have buyback.
Oh man.
Does any of them do? No. All of these guys who are dead are gonna remain dead. Question is if CLG really knows this.
They can't push fast enough anyway. Or maybe they can.
They could. It's a full minute to push, and Luna being gone, that's...
But to claim a GG and knock it over committed, because you still gotta remember there's a lot of disable coming out from Rubick.
Yeah, they're still scared about overcommitting because Tinker respawns, so they will just chill.
Mm-hmm. Not to mention also, Pike has Fireback is on cooldown too. So if it was Lacoste as well as Morphling pushing in and they lost the Morphling, that would be a Rax for PB. If that Morphling is gone, this is over.
Yeah, but that was the way I was thinking about this Luna. If she was gone, this is over. But she is gone and they are not forcing too much, but now they are going. Because they have...
This is so late though. Tinker's now back.
But still two heroes dead.
It's already preparing bottom lane.
Rax and just get out. And this is what I want to do. Just kill Rax and get out.
Marsh the machine. Fortification, not there. Yep, there goes Rax.
Lacoste has to back out earlier than Pika. Because he has no way to survive a Hex.
Can they catch him up? Waveform already used. Nah, there's extra support around the place.
It's a free Rax, at least, for CLG, but this game is so far from over.
Uh-huh.
Luna does not care about Mega Creeps. I'm telling you, all in the stream. Mega Creeps doesn't even matter against Luna if she has these kind of items. She can kill them easily. So, it's not Mega Creeps yet, though, but Big Creeps, she doesn't even notice it's Big Creeps.
PB making another move. They're pushing back down the middle lane. How long to the next Roshan? He's 2.5 minutes away now.
I'm thinking about what she's going for with this Demon Edge.
Monkey King
Bar. I'm thinking she will go Divine.
No.
I think she will do it.
No.
Yeah,
not without Nagus. Not without Nagus. She will not go Divine without Nagus.
I think she will.
It's ballsy.
It's ballsy and she can do it. You saw how long she survived on the top lane.
That's true. And of course you get the heal from the Satanic when you combine it with the Rapier.
Yeah, and you will kill everything so quickly. Mm-hmm. But right now, it's pretty far off in the future. They are pushing on top lane. This is what's happening right now. And it's going to be a 5-on-5 fight and CLG defending. And still no buyback on Morphling. He has nothing to use his money for, though. So, yeah.
We're going again.
With the bank, that's useless.
Here we go again. Shock's trying to kill off this creep wave and making sure it doesn't enter the base. But the Martian Machine starting off and the creep wave now inside. Backdoor regen will not have his effect. And here we go again.
The constant march of Tinker, he has so much mana, he can just keep doing this. Rax should go down, I feel. Unless there's a bigger ES ulti, he's looking for it.
He's waiting for the moment, but he's not going to find it. Owie, now coming in. There we go, Blink in, but it's not a big ES ulti. And Owie just turns around, mops him up, then wants to go for Lacoste, but the Rax, damn it, the Rax! There's fortification, but maybe Pycat! Oh, Pycat's in trouble! The Shaggy will buy time! Owie is locked in Lacoste! Focus firing down Owie! Owie is gone! Morphling will way back out again, sneaking on low life! He's trying to retreat as well, but it is just too much! Even the Panthers was bringing him down! The Rax is gonna still be brought down by Bottom Bottom! There is no fortification! They've got Jakiro held in place! It's only a melee! Jakiro's gonna go down! And what are you saying, bottom lane? Uriah sneaking back here to defend.
Get bugged? I'm perma-silenced.
Is he? Oh, that's not cool.
He is in base right now and he's not using his Fade Bolt to... He's trying to restart.
Oh, man. They got so close. So close to bringing down the Morphling. But that Shackle. That Shackle from Lacoste just won CLG this game.
It was so clutch. It caught up. Was it the Tinker who was in the rare?
Yeah, it was
Maui. So he caught the two biggest heroes and just held them while Morphling was being single targeted. And he just barely survived with Morphling. It was so clutch. And buyback is only a minute away from Morphling and it looks like they are able to defend and are gonna pressure, definitely gonna pressure now on the Radiant team, and there's no buyback.
Here we go. Lacoste's gonna pick up Tides of Time. He's locked in position. Can't do any more damage.
He can't use any spells. The game is still bugged for him. This is so sad to see. Rubick can't do anything.
If he uses the Heal Scepter or Gem... Oh no, there we go. He's got Fae Bolt. I'm just waiting for Fog to arrive. We have to go back in here. Look at this middle lane. The wave pushing it. It's a triple lane. And while Pycat... He TP'd in on this one, sneaking Yule Scepters up in towards the air. Pycat held in position, Fog trying to rocket him down. They're trying to get the Hex, but Fog, he's fighting against the big creeps. Get away from that, Ghost Scepter will pop. Pycat's just like, sweet!
Wow. And there's a buyback from that hero and Enchantress, but they're still not the most important hero, and I don't know.
Buy time for Luna. Buy time. Oh, is it Roshan again? Roshan's in 10 seconds, 5 seconds.
He used a spell. Never mind, they do. Yeah, they're gonna kill Roshan.
TLG do not want to throw anything in this game. They have to win every single game. And yeah, just pinging on Roshan, he's up pretty soon, boys.
And it is a big thing to point out. You are right. Like, CLG, they're currently two down here in the grand final out of the best of five.
Games in a row.
Yeah, and this is a 72-minute game already. Look at Roshan's dead. How many cheese does CLG now have? Do they use them all?
Yeah, I think they used both, to be honest.
Yeah, there's cheese on Miracle, and there's Aegis Immortal on Lacoste.
They have two cheese. No, okay, it's only one cheese.
Morphling is 8.3k gold.
Yeah.
And his buyback is off cooldown.
Just buy a Buritza now. Lincoln's is not as good as Buritza, or even buy up the Satanic.
Yeah.
He could be stronger than he is right now, but he needs something aside from the Lincoln's. Illusions are great late game, but Lincoln's is not as big, I feel. Mm-hmm. Sure, it saves him from one spell, but Tinker can just rearm in 1 second, throw 10 spells on him.
Yeah. Still going to point out right now the fact that all heroes are back up again. Rubick is now going to come back up, but this top lane, the melee rack still went down. That was the one rack the PB still have intact. So it's going to gain momentum. Bit by bit, little by little. We've already seen how Luna's been able to deal with the middle as well as the bot racks. And if you look back what was about 10 minutes ago, where we were like, oh my god, PB could possibly win this, it's even a little bit further that way. They are 8,000 worth of experience behind. They are 12,000 worth of gold behind and two racks down. But it is still doable because of this amazing Luna Manda-style push that's coming out from that. But also the fact that now CLG, they have to split their attention to top as well. So PB will be quite happy to fight this from inside their own base. They'll push out if they need to, but they don't need to do that until the next Roshan. And he's already down. So they just fight from inside their base, have enough money for buyback, which at this point, Luna does not have. And just see if they can win this off. But Fog, he stalls up the middle lane. That's three waves of March of the Machines. Maybe even four going across the middle lane right now.
Yeah, he's just spamming it and... Oh, this is... This is a horrible position,
smoke?
And they are doing a desperate smoke gang. They are going out.
They're
going
to find Miracle. There's a blink up. They catch out Miracle, bringing him down. Now the blink in. It's going to go in there. Miracle, the BKB, breaks it out. But Owie, he's going to try and right-click. But Owie can't right-click anything down. Pikehead's here in the fight. There's your Echo Slam. BKB's a worn-off. And GG is the call. Counter-Logic Gaming takes 74 minutes and rough amount of seconds. And they will take out Pot and Bottom here in the third game. We are going to go to a fourth.
11,000 on Morphling. Fuck this game, mystery.
But that is going to be GG for this game. And look at the fortress, how fast it would have taken to bring it down.
Yeah.
Little to no time whatsoever. The 28-48 at the end. It does not feel like that. It does not feel like that at all.
It was a tense game.
Yeah.
It was not easy.
But, guys, we shall return game number four after what I'm going to be pretty sure it's going to be a break.
At least.
Just a little one. Have yourself a breather. Go and drain your bowels. And then refresh them up with a beverage. You're going to need to be refreshed for this next game coming up. Game number four, Catalogic Gaming vs. Pot and Bottom for the Pro Dota World Cup Grand Final. Stick around, we'll be back.